Hello. How are you doing? It's been a while. But I finally got some time to stream. And I'll probably stream until Obother comes online. So, last time we left off with the PCB done for the PlayStation 1 reset mod, which you can see here. Just to give you an idea of the size, yeah, I'll just show you with the webcam. It's this little thing. Not sure how much I'm going to be able to show, but it's rather small. Try it. So, as you can see, it's really small. It's like 1 centimeter on 1.5. So this is the actual size, 14.5 millimeter wide, 12 millimeter high, and we're going to install a PicMic controller on it. Which is the same as the one we used on this breadboard, but in a surface mount package. Let's see if I can give you a closer look at it. Where did I put my tweezers? This will have to do. So it should get installed like this. And I still have a capacitor to install, which is this one, VGK 10 microfarad, 16 volts. Here are my two tweezers. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is just solder it on, and then on the back side there are some pads to program it. I can show you that in the schematic, it would be a bit easier. So this is the front side. Those connections go to the PlayStation, and on the back these are the programming buttons. Okay, so let's see if I can solder this thing on. God damn it. The band on the capacitor is the positive side. So I have to install it the other way and up here. I'm gonna turn it around. And I'm gonna try to heat up the pad I just added solder onto, and add the capacitor on top. You want it to be a bit more to the there we go. So I have a little bit of space to solder the other side. I'm going to straighten it up a bit so it doesn't interfere with the chip later. Like that. Probably fine. Now let's try adding the chip. Gonna try and tape it down because it's moving too much. Just a bit of double-sided tape. Like that. And let's paste it right here. It's gonna be a bit wobbly now, but that should be fine. Trying to get it straight and as much in the middle as I can get it. And now I'm gonna add a little bit of solder on each leg. Doesn't have to be much. I'm trying to get the tip of my solder clean
so I get new solder on the pads every time. Not going to focus, is it? I think everything's connected. Let's see if we can add a few wires. To program the chip. Get a little bit of solder on those pads. It's not much, but it should be enough to make a connection. Going to use miniature solid wire. Rather small. Doesn't have to be very long, it's just for programming. The same length. That's 4. What I can do now is burn a bit of the wire back. Going to do that on both sides already, and a bit more on this side. Because I'm going to attach that side to a header pin. Alright, that's done. Now to solder it on. Let me try and get you a bit closer if I can. Caleb, how are you doing? I need 5 header pins. That just hit the camera. 3, 5, okay. So the idea would be to solder those cables on here. And hopefully I can do that. So I'm gonna pre-tin the headers. Okay, so I have to solder them like they are on the board, so like I can just plug them in here without any issues. So I'm just going to take the wire, place it next to the header pins, and solder them on. Let me try to change the light. Let's try like that. It's a bit in the way, but fine. Like that, that's one. Yeah, I'm not blocking the view too much. There we go. Now it's just a matter of programming and installing it in the PlayStation. That's still open since the last time. Let's try and get it out without breaking anything. Okay, there we go. Not the best soldering job, but it did the job. So, looking at how I have it connected right here, the white wire is going to the MCLR. Yeah, I think that's the one. Gray is ground. Here, that's the programming, I believe. No, gray is the power.
Let's take it down to Google. Okay, so one is MCLR, which means that this one should be the one where the arrow is. Let me get the webcam back up. So if you look at the PCB, the first one is VPP/MCLR, and that should go to the arrow. So I'm gonna disconnect this and connect it here. We will check it's right. Looks like it is. Yeah, let's see if we can get it programmed. Okay, so I'm gonna open IPE, which is the programming tool for Microchip PIC. Okay, so it looks like it's connected to the programmer. We want to power the target. Voltage doesn't really matter, but I like to keep it the same as the PlayStation. We want to use high voltage programming. And let's do the recommended settings. Let's close. Can we? Let's just close. X file, which is this one. And let's try to program. Program complete. Verify. Verification successful. Alright, so now we just have to install it, I guess. So that's not needed anymore. I wonder if I can solder these test wires I have onto the mod just to test. I'm gonna remove the wires. Yeah, verification was successful, so it should be fine to remove. Like that. That was not in frame, I'm sorry. Okay, so going to put some solder onto all those pads, same as I did for the backside. Trying to get a better view.
don't want to add too much solder, just want to be a little bit. So just little balls of solder, that's more than enough. And now I'm going to my focus. Why are you not focusing? Never mind. So I'm going to remove the wire that I soldered on the back of the connector from the breadboard, and I'm going to try to use that. On the on the mod chip. This is my reset. So let's see if we can do that. So I've labeled every wire. So that's my 3-volt, that's my command, right here, clock. This is my data, and this is my slave select. The blue one is obviously ground. And the reset is right here for now, this orange one. So looking at the PCB, I need 5 volts, I need 3.5 volts right here, ground is on the other side, down below is a reset, and from top to bottom, command, data, clock. Save select. So let's just do simple connections. And now with the pawn cable, and I'll change that later. And so my feet start to tremble, they lift up. So command goes right here. Then it's the data. Should be this one. Just came off. Then it's the clock. And the last one is slave select. So it's all wired up now. Let's remove this. The mod, I'm just gonna leave it hanging like that. The control ports go right there, flex cable goes right here, so let's try and put some power into it. The controller, do I have a memory card somewhere? Yeah, right here. I'm just blind. Like so. Let's plug in the cable for the TV. Let's see, does it have power? No, light doesn't turn on. Let's plug in the TV. Let's see if the PlayStation is still wired into the TV. I don't think it is. No, it's not. So give me a second to wire it up. I'm gonna mute for a minute.
Alright, let's give it a test. It turns on. TV is on. Vistron logo. No recurrent. I'm just going to browse the memory card. See if that still works. Yeah, that looks like it's working. Let me try and change the webcam to the TV. There you go. Good old DRT. I'm just going to back out. And let's see. The reset should go on if I press L2, R2, start select. And it does not. Shit. That's anticlimactic. I wonder why it's not working. Am I pressing the right buttons? Yeah, select start, L2, R2. Yeah, it's debug time. Let's get the scope out. Sorry for the noise of the scope, I haven't changed the fan, nor have I added the temperature controller, something I want to add. This still works. Cool. So you can see what I see. Not perfect, but it works. Okay, let's take the probes.
So I'm gonna measure from ground to the voltage. That looks like 3.5 volts, so that's fine. I hope you can see that too. Yeah. Let me change the... Hey, Probotics! Yes, that's the Rivalscope, the DS1052E. I made the program a while ago, a few streams ago, to show it on stream. It was actually something meant for the DS1054Z, but the frame rate is just completely shit. Let me remove the webcam for now so I can change it back. I have the program on GitHub if you want. It's not updated with the latest version, but it should work. You do need the SDL library and the National Instruments Visa driver. Let's see the webcam. Yeah, mine is not that better. This thing is falling down. Come on. There. Let's push that up a bit. First things first, did I connect everything right? Slave select goes to slave select, clock goes to clock, data goes to data, command goes to command, the reset goes to the reset, ground goes to ground, and 3.5 volts is fine. Okay, so no error there. Let's get the probe. Let's see. What should we do? Let's try to probe the command and the clock or the data first. Let's see if I can grab ground in here from a second probe. Looks like I can. And then I need to probe this. One little downside about the DS1052E is I cannot control the buttons while it's streaming to the PC. So for now I've added a little bit of code to unlock when my mouse is over the program window, so then I can change everything on the scope. So let's
A bit jittery. Let me one shot it. Try trigger. Let's try change the trigger. Yeah, two seconds are stuck. You guys can see. Yeah, we just have to work with this. Okay, so the data we have to read. Should be in here somewhere. For the command, this is for the data. So we should be getting 5A41, and let's see if that's actually the case. The code reads on the rising edge, if I remember correctly, and it is least significant bit first. So this 1000010, which is 41.
Everything's gonna be okay.
Let's see if I wrote it down on a GitHub page.
But that doesn't mean that you should
probably stop. Didn't. There, write it in the wiki.
A nightmare that you thought was real but really isn't.
So on the data we should get FF and then the ID of the controller, which is 41. That's what we just saw. So 1000 is 1 0010 is 4, so 41. And if I move a bit further up, let me try to stabilize it, then we get 1011, which is D.
It's not exactly clear whether they even
0101
could be shown to in the physical.
That's something else than that I just had. Wasn't it?
Physics finds a use for them. That's great. But if not,
anyways. Okay, seems like what's let's see if I can change. Five A, which is the idea. Data after that is just the button presses. Let's see, that's the up arrow. That's the up arrow. That's the down, left, right. That's the start. Nothing more. I better not delete the same game. Okay, let's move over a bit more. L1, L2, R1, R2, square, triangle. X.
That's great.
Can see select button. Let's try to make it a bit more smooth. It's right there. That's my select. Okay, so it looks like all the data is correct. Let's measure. Let's measure the slave select. Yeah, it is low. It should be low during transmission for the controller 1. Let's check data. Command. Let's see what the command sends. So, command sends a 1 hexadecimal, which it is. The second byte should be 42, which is 0100 is a 2, 0010 is a 4, so that's also correct. The other bytes have no meaning. Do I still have that? Yeah, I do. Oh. So I have some debug functionality, which is basically the same as what the Arduino does, sending data out of the UART. So if I recompile this, like that. Oh, I have to flash it again, so I'll have to rewire the backside of the mod PCB, which is going to be a pain. Let's see, the UART, which pin did I connect it to? UART is on RC3. Get the data sheet up. This is the one we need, RC3. So let's see if we can connect the programmer back, and let's see if I can attach the FTDI module on the RC3. Yeah, it'll be fun. I'm gonna unpower everything. Disconnect the probes. Like that. Lots of wires in the way. Okay, let's see. This is what I'm going to use.
It's a PL2303 and I just want to connect the receive and ground. If I still have a wire, yeah, gonna put that to the side for now. How am I going to solder this back on? So I need to solder 5 wires to the back of the PCB, which is used for programming. I have to make sure not to mess up the wires. I think that should do it. Let's double check. First wire, first pin. Second wire, second pin. Third to the third one. 4 is correct, and the fifth too. So let's put it back. Let's see. What did I say earlier? So the MCLR, the first one, should go to the arrow, so I have to plug it in like that. Yeah, so like this. I've disconnected the controller from the board so I don't power the whole PlayStation from the PIC kit. Yeah, let's go back to the PC. Open IPE. That's strange. I've been there.
Did it give an error when compiling, or did it? Let's see. Seems like I just forgot to add the function name at the top. Let's see if I can find it now. Hate all the folders the microchip IDE makes. Oh, I know. Let's double check all the settings. Verification successful. So yeah, I still need to wire the UART. Let's do that. For that I need this RC3. Get a smaller wire for that. Okay, so I need the black one is ground, which I need to solder on. Let's try to do that without burning myself. That ground is connected, and now I need to find RC3, which is the fourth one starting from below. That's not going to be an easy one to do, is it? Let's try and add a bit of solder. And then
That was easier than expected. Now why did I throw away the USB cable that I need for this thing? Give me just a second to search for the correct cable. Ah, it's right here. So I'm just going to plug it in the computer. Like so. So the board is on. Let's see on the desktop. Board available. Board 3. Serial compo 3, that's the baud rate. Is it the same issue we had the last stream? With the stupid driver. Yeah, I don't want a prolific driver. Let's try to open it up in Putty again. Yeah, this will work. So let's connect it back to the PlayStation. The UART serial connected to the motherboard. I have the controller board connected to the motherboard too, and I've plugged it back into the PlayStation with the flex cable. So let's see what it does when I turn it on. I'm going to turn the TV back on and turn the PlayStation on. I hope some data is going to come out of it. Let's plug the controller back in. Mm-hmm.
let's see. Doesn't look like anything is coming through. Let's just print something when initializing the UI. Compiled fine without errors. Let's reload it in the IPE. Let's turn off the PlayStation, disconnect the controller, reconnect the programmer. Programming complete. Let's verify. Yeah, that seems to have worked. And let's try again, I guess. But first, let's plug the controller back in. Wait, why is this not seated correctly? There. Okay. Pity. Let's turn it back on. Nothing. Okay. That's not what I had expected. Let's see if I could just blink an LED. This is all the UART initialization, I'm just going to do that, and I'm going to this too. So that RC3 is set up as a normal output, and infinite loop. Let's add a delay. Let's give it a delay of 10 milliseconds. So every 10 milliseconds, the output of RC3 should flip with this XOR operation. I'm going to turn on the oscilloscope back on. Unplug the controller ports. Let's try to defect this. I don't need this for now. Let's see, I need to reprogram it, so yep, that should go like this. Let's try. I don't care. Let's try reprogramming it. Program complete. Verify. Let's attach the oscilloscope right there. Let's see. Is it being powered by the it's being powered, so let's turn the oscilloscope back on. Is it plugged in? I think it is. Yeah, should be. Seeing something else. I'm gonna remove the PK3. What the fuck? Why are you doing this now? There we go. Just have to unplug it and plug it back in. So I'm gonna put the programmer back in because that's the power of the mod. Yeah. And I'm gonna probe part C3. I think that's RC3. There's no voltage, so let's see. Yeah, yeah. Channel fuck off. Do we have power? Do we have? Nope, we don't have blinking output. That's weird. There's really no difference between the SOIC package and the through hole one I have on the breadboard here, where the program works without issues. Just let me double check the data sheet. This is a 20 pin SOIC that I have. This one. I don't have an RC3. That's the problem. I've attached it to RA3 now, so let's move it to one down. I don't think RC5 is used for anything. Let's take the code. RC5 is the reset. So I cannot use that. Oh, it's weird. RC3 is right here. It's been 7. So let's move the orange wire down. Can I measure this first? Looks like it's doing something. Maybe not. Anyways, let's remove the probe. It's gonna be a bit tricky to solder because it's right next to the reset. Let's
to add a little bit more solder to the GPON cable. That's too much though. Yeah, it's attached to it. Cool. So, damn it. I don't have a drop command yet. But that was a drop. What was I gonna do? The oscilloscope can stay on. I need to change the code back that I commented out. I want to have UR back. So, I need to remove all this, like that. But successfully, let's reconnect. Program. Verify. Let's get the UART back on. So that is on. Let's open Betty. Serial. Let's put ground on ground and the transmit on the receive. And let's fire off the programmer, fire it back on. Oh, it's doing something. Okay, let's add let's add a UR point right here. Let's also add a delay of a few milliseconds so we don't get spammed. Yes, reload.
There we go, that's our main loop. And I need a P break, so I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, so we have communication with the board, as you can see here, the main loop gets sent every 100 milliseconds. Is that going to affect the main loop itself? I don't think so. Well, because everything is interfaced. Okay, so I can leave it like that. And I just need to connect it back to the PlayStation to be done, see what the output is. So I'm gonna disconnect it from the it. Yeah, I'm gonna disconnect it from here. I'm gonna put the connector back into the PlayStation. So, is it still receiving stuff? No. Okay. So, I'm gonna turn on the PlayStation. Hey, it's any PlayStation 1. So, that's already. It's really nice to see. There is our data. Let's see, can I freeze it for a second? Command is zero. Data and command is the same. Except for the first byte, the one is shifted. That shouldn't happen. Are they touching each other? Let's inspect. They don't look like they're touching each other.
command and data are right next to each other.
But yeah, it looks like data is getting the command bytes. Because data should be FF followed by the ID by 415A, and the command should be 1 hex and then 42 hex. Okay, let me measure that with the oscilloscope and both probes, so turn channel 2 back on. Get ground right there. Let's measure the clock. Like so. Let's go back to the start. And then let's take channel 2. My brother is gonna start pretty soon, so I'm gonna stream for like half an hour, and when he comes on, then we can raid him. Let's see, what did I want to measure? Clock is already done. I want to measure the data. Trying not to short anything. And then let's grab ground somewhere else. So this is data. As you can see, the first byte is FF and the second one is 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 is FF 41. Sorry, I'm burping. So which is what we should see here and what we are not getting in here. So what the fuck? I'm correctly measuring data, so it's not like it's not like I have a short between command and data. I can also move the cursor on the TV and open the memory cards, so I know there's no issues there. So it must be software related.
Breathe.
Here's the data. Here's command. So how the fuck do I stop? Like, data dump for routing happens before. Yeah, it doesn't look like anything is changing when I'm pressing any buttons. Why is it doing that though? This device should be connections. So RA2 should be slave select. Which is the fourth one? It's pin 11. Pin 11 is slave select. Then RC0 is clock, which is the one right below, then data, then command. And there is no connection between those. RC5 is reset, which is pin 5. Yeah, the ball looks right. RA2, RC0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2. Did add the volatile keyword. So I thought maybe I forgot that, but it's right there. And I'm correctly reading buffer 1 from the SPI into the command buffer, and the SPI2 into the data buffer. So, what the fuck? Why is it doing that? I don't really know what to print to figure out where the issue is. The fact that it has the same data makes me think the one is overflowing to the other, but it's weird, it shouldn't. Yeah, just like you say, also. Data is consistent too. It's always command is always 0, then 142.0.0.0, 142.0, and data is always 142.B0s, 142.2.0s. So it's not like it's shifting or doing anything weird. Let me turn the equation off and then on again. Let's see what happens. Is this the same? Yep. That's exactly the same. So, did I mess up the initialization? Wait a minute. Let's see. So the slave select for both SPIs in the Sigma controller is RB2. The clock for both SPI is 0. The SPI 1 is connected to RC1. SPI 1 to RC1. RC1 is set to be data. Is that how RC1 is data? Then it is connected to SPI1 SSP1. So this is not right. I must have mixed the data and command in the code. Should be an easy fix. Still weird that it's reading incorrect data of the command. Something like that, I suppose. SSP2 connected to RC2. RC2 is command. RC2 is 8, which is command. Okay, so we need to read the command on SPI2, which means that SPI1 is the data. Okay. Yeah, let's try again. Been successful. Let's reload. Turn position off. Let's see. This should go like that. Then let's do that. Okay, so connect to the picket. Turn off the oscilloscope, making too much noise. Program. Verify. Verification successful. Disconnect it from the programmer. Connect the controller board back to the PlayStation. Like that, turn the PlayStation back on. So, yeah, my cable is the best one. Making a bit of note. So my data is correct right now. If I press a button, you can see the FF, this one, changed to BF. And if I release the down button on the controller, inch back to FF. Let's see if I press R1, L1, the second FF changed to FA, and if I release it, come back to FF. So my data is correct. Actually no. Yeah, here is correct. So it should be F. Should it be FF? Yeah, it should be FF 41 5A, and then the status of the status of the switches. Oh right. Yeah, it's might be an issue with synchronizing the bits or bytes or whatever. Anyways, I'm still getting FF 415A. So my command is still on my data for some reason now, which it shouldn't be. This is so weird. The thing worked the past stream and I didn't change anything. So this is the peripheral to set which input or output I want to connect to which module. So I want to connect SPI1 to RC1. So RC1 is here, which is 11 in hex. It is in the code, then RC2 is 12x, which is also correct in here. RC0 is 10x, and RA2 is 2x. Yep. It all looks fine. SPI 1 and 2 are set up identically. Is it overflowing right here? Like the command plus plus and data data count plus plus is not, I don't check if it's bigger than the data buffer can be. So maybe that's the issue. Yeah, probably. I'm gonna remove this. The delay is probably messing up everything. Because the SPI is 200 kilohertz, if I remember correctly. So that's 5 microseconds. It's 20,000 bits it can receive in 100 milliseconds. So, yeah. The delay was not supposed to be there. This is probably not very good to do. The command should be, the command counter should be checked before every write to the buffer. So this, I just hope the code has time to actually read the I just hope the MARC controller has enough time to read the SPI bytes going in and executing this if statement at the same time before it triggers another SPI. So if it doesn't, then it's probably going to miss a few bytes, and that's not good either. So I'm gonna do this here too, just for being consistent. Buffer should be the same size. So by adding that, I can probably leave the 100 milliseconds in there, but yeah, let's try without it. Actually reload. Now you can reload. Let's turn the PlayStation back off. Disconnect the control board. Connect the programmer and program. Very fine. Verification successful. Disconnect the programmer, turn on the PlayStation, pick up pretty. Control board back. It instantly writes PlayStation 1 mod, PlayStation is turning on, and there's our data. Let's see. Hey, it's working! Let me get you a view of the TV. Yeah, we figured it out. I'm just turning the webcam around so I can show you the TV. I'll explain it in just a second. Yeah, it was an issue with the extra code I've written for debugging it, and also an issue with the with setting up the how can I say it? With mixing the data and commands in the code compared to the hardware. So that's my TV, PlayStation. Let's try to get control out of the way of all the cables. So just a simple controller, and I'm gonna press L2 and let's try not to get a free video. I'm also in pajamas, so probably not the best. This camera mount is really annoying. Always moving there. So that was for a digital controller, so if I press this button, the PlayStation will see it as an analog controller. So it's gonna read the analog sticks, but if I press the same buttons, fuck. It should work. Let's and the serial, I think, yes. Let's change the F7. So I have programmed the analog control as 5A53 to look at. Data is 73 5A73. I had two analog controls, so I might have removed the incorrect one. That's okay. But it should work if I change. 7 3. Let's just double check with No Caches website. Here somewhere. Yes. Yes. 5A73, 5A5. So I guess I should go. I don't have one that has a green LED. I can test this one. We have this one. Yes. I guess I'll add both. Has Obother already started streaming? Then we need to add it somewhere in here. Let's recompile, turn the PlayStation off. Flash the microcontroller program. Verify. Successful. Okay. Disconnect the programmer. connect the controller board back onto the motherboard of the PlayStation, turn the PlayStation on, and that back in view. Get the button on screen going way too fast, but it looks like the data is fine. So this view. So same as before, without the red LED on. So it instantly reset. If I press the analog button and then press the same button, resets again, which means that the code works. And then I still have one thing to test. I need a gun. Give me a moment. I'm gonna fight the gun controller. Connected the white controller and I connected the gun controller, which is this one. Has two buttons and one trigger, and it should reset if I press all the buttons. So this is the A button, B button, and the trigger. The TV, yeah, the position reset itself. So awesome, it works. I guess I still had some issues with the code that wasn't up to date with the hardware, so I probably messed up the hardware. But it's an easy fix. And yeah, it works again. Cool. Yeah. Let's bring the bottom. So thanks for watching. If I ever do something like that again, I'll probably stream it. It's actually really fun to do. So, see you next time. Bye.